Hi students, welcome to my channel Thoughts of Physics.
In the video series of moving charges and magnetism, in this class I am going to explain the force between two parallel current carrying conductors. So already we have discussed that when a current carrying conductor is placed in uniform magnetic field, it experiences a magnetic force. So let us consider two conductors A and B placed at a distance of D parallel to each other. IA is the current passing through the conductor A and IB is the current passing through the conductor B. Now these two conductors are separated by a distance D and these two are parallel to each other. Now when a current IA is passing through the conductor A, which produces a magnetic field around this conductor. In the magnetic field produced by the conductor A, the conductor B is present. So due to the magnetic field produced by the conductor A, the conductor B, it experiences a force. So let us find the force experienced by the conductor B in the presence of magnetic field produced by the conductor A. Now first let us find the magnetic field produced by the conductor A when IA current is passing through the conductor at the site of B, that is the magnetic field due to the conductor A at the site of conductor B. That is BA. B is the magnetic field. A is magnetic field produced by the conductor A. That is equal to, already we have discussed the magnetic field due to current carrying conductor is mu naught by 2 pi I by R. Here BA, the magnetic field produced by the conductor A, is equal to mu naught by 2 pi IA, because in the conductor A the current is IA by D. Why we have taken here D means the conductor B is at a distance of the conductor A. Now this is the magnetic field produced at the site of B conductor. Due to this magnetic field, the conductor B will experience a force. Now the force experienced by the conductor B, which is in the magnetic field of the conductor A. Now we know that the force experienced by the current carrying conductor is, the formula is ILB sin theta, where I is the current passing through the conductor and L is the length of the conductor and B is the magnetic field in which the conductor is placed and theta is the angle between length and the magnetic field. Here FBA is the force experienced by the conductor B due to the conductor A. That is equal to, so the formula is ILB sin theta IB, because in the B conductor the current passing through the B conductor is IB. So IB L, the length of the conductor B is, let us say, L, and the conductor B which is placed in the magnetic field produced by A conductor. So the magnetic field produced by the conductor A is, that is BA into sin theta. Now IB L BA, already we have determined here the magnetic field produced by the conductor A, mu naught by 2 pi IA by D into sin theta. Now here the angle between the conductor and the magnetic field is 90 degrees. The conductor, that means the length of the conductor and the magnetic field is 90 degrees. So that's why theta is 90 degrees. So sin 90 becomes 1. Then the force experienced by the conductor B in the presence of magnetic field produced by the conductor A, that is FBA, is equal to mu naught by 2 pi, if we simplify this, mu naught by 2 pi IA into IB capital L by D, because sin 90 becomes 1. This is, let us say, equation number 1. So equation number 1 gives the force experienced by the conductor B, which is in the presence of magnetic field of conductor A. From the Fleming's left hand rule, this force acts towards A because the A conductor attracts the B conductor. The currents in both the conductors are in the same direction. So now when the currents are in the same direction, the force is attractive force. Now this force acts towards the conductor A. That means A conductor attracts the B conductor. Now this is the force experienced by B due to A. Similarly, when a current IB passing through the conductor B, the B conductor also which produces a magnetic field in this region. In the magnetic field produced by the B conductor, the conductor A is present. So the conductor A will experience a force due to the conductor B. So whatever we have done in the previous case, here we are doing the converse. That means previously we have discussed that due to the magnetic field produced by the A conductor, B will experience force. Similarly, due to the magnetic field produced by the conductor B, A will experience force. Now, so the magnetic field produced by the conductor B at the site of the conductor A, BB is the magnetic field produced by the conductor B, that is equal to mu naught by 2 pi. The current passing through the B conductor is IB over D. Why we have taken here D means the A conductor which is at a distance of D from B. So this is the magnetic field at the site of A conductor. Due to that magnetic field, A conductor will experience a force. Now the force experienced by conductor A, which is in the magnetic field of conductor B, that is FAB. FAB means force experienced by the conductor A, which is in the presence of the magnetic field produced by the conductor B. That is equal to, we know the formula, ILB sin theta. The force experienced by the current carrying conductor is ILB sin theta. So IA is the current passing through the conductor A, and L is the length of the conductor, and BB, because the conductor A is present in the magnetic field produced by the B conductor. So that's why BB into sin theta. Now IA, L, BB, the magnetic field produced by the B conductor is mu naught by 2 pi IB by D into theta sin 90, because so the length and the magnetic field both are perpendicular at this point. So that's why sin 90. Now if you rearrange the terms, mu naught by 2 pi IA into IB capital L by D, sin 90 becomes 1. This is equation number 2. So equation number 2 gives the force experienced by the conductor A, which is in the presence of the magnetic field produced by the B conductor. So from the Fleming's left hand rule, this force acts towards B. So now FAB, FAB means force experienced by the A conductor due to the B. It acts towards the B. That means the B conductor attracts the A conductor. Previously the conductor A attracts B. Now the conductor B attracts A. That means this is a mutual attraction. When the currents are in the same direction, the force is attractive force. So now from equation number 1 and from equation number 2, we can observe that the force experienced by the B due to A is equal to the force experienced by A due to B in magnitude, but opposite in direction. If you observe that these two forces are opposite in direction, so you can say that FAB bar is equal to minus FBA bar. This minus indicates that the two forces are in the opposite direction. Now the force per unit length of each conductor, force per unit length means F by L. Then if you take this L this side, the force per unit length of each conductor becomes mu naught by 2 pi IA into IB by D. The D is the distance between the two conductors. IA and IB are the currents passing through the conductors. Mu naught is the permeability of free space. Now this is the force per unit length on each conductor. Now here we have discussed that when the currents are in the same direction, the force is attractive force. Now when the currents are in the opposite direction, here we have shown IA is a upwards and IB is downwards. Both are in the opposite direction. When the currents are in the opposite direction, the force is repulsive. That means both the conductors repel each other. Now, let us define 1 ampere from this relation. So, already we have discussed that the force per unit length is F by L is equal to mu naught by 2 pi Ia Ib over D. This is the force per unit length. Now, let us consider Ia is equal to Ib is equal to 1 ampere. That is unit current. 1 ampere. And D, the two conductors are placed at a distance of 1 meter. Per unit length, we are calculating this. Now, F is equal to, from this formula, L is 1 meter, that is force per unit length we are calculating. F is equal to the value of mu naught, we know 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7 over 2 pi. Ia and Ib and D, all the values are 1. Then if you cancel, you will get the force F is equal to 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 Newton. So this is per meter length, per unit length of that wire. It experiences, the conductors experience this much force. The conductors experience this much force. Now, from that we can define 1 ampere. So, 1 ampere is defined as the constant current maintained in each of two long straight conductors placed at 1 meter distance in vacuum experience a force of 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 Newton per meter length. When two long straight conductors are placed at a distance of 1 meter in vacuum, they experience 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 Newton per meter length. Then the currents passing through the conductors is said to be 1 ampere. So that is about the force between two parallel current carrying conductors and the definition of ampere. Thank you.